All right, we are getting underway. Gonna decide stages.
Do. 3 exclamation points means it's business.
I would be shocked if they didn't go Smashville first game. Mm. Like, come on, it's crew battle. You gotta start somewhere.
All right, my tweet is out. Where's your tweet?
I have.
I meant just for them too. Right, I wasn't trying to exclude you. Like, I wasn't trying to.
Let me tell you.
Get that team rivalry going pretty quick. Nah. We're back here. We're a neutral party for now.
Dude, where the heck is your tweet? All right.
All right, hopping into it.
FD first game.
Fist bumps all around, and we are going to get this crew battle started.
All right. Fireball's coming out. Both players going to be really cautious. The fair immediately power shielded. Yeah. Typical Luigi hits right
like
there.
Like we saw in the stamina, that is an early indicator of a lot of percentage being taken on and a lot of advantage going to the player that gets it. Yeah. So.
Oh, egg lay.
Gets the egg. Oh, actually, I don't know. What's really interesting is that I start to see Yoshi's attack the person getting out of the egg instead of attacking the egg while they're in it.
Yeah, I think they have... I don't know. I think there's a 2-frame window where you can actually hit them before they input an action. So it's, like, really hard to catch them out of the egg, which is why they're just kind of attacking the egg.
And I only say that because I think it's because they're mashing to get out of the egg so much that they might not catch themselves throwing an attack once they get out of the egg.
Yeah.
And if Yoshi can predict that, that's a free attack for him to get right there.
Yeah, exactly. And even if they throw an attack, you can do something with it.
Right.
Oh, that shield pressure.
Even, but that is a whittled down shield. Ooh. Almost went for the spike. He is trying to take out Luck here.
Oh, that Nair is actually going to break up that jab combo. Luck trying to get on his feet here, trying to get back on stage. It's going to be a little hard to approach Yoshi. But getting those jabs, Yoshi now.
But the up smash will claim first stock for Team James.
Yeah, trying to get that Nair to get... Trying to get that Nair to get out of the way. That was actually Team Pasta with that kill.
Right.
Oh, boy.
But he is tacking on a lot of damage. He is in poised position to get a stock take on. The thing you... I'm trying to flood my mind with so many different terms and thoughts here.
I got you.
Like, stocks are so important in crew battles.
Yeah, definitely.
And the huge percentage divide right now... that's why Luck is playing so defensively, just throwing out fireballs and almost nothing else there.
Trying to get that grab from that mix-up.
He's tacking on damage as much as he can, and he's just trying to keep himself safe so he can get the 2-0 instead of the potential 1 on himself before he gets him down. Great, yeah, pop out of shield, but a forward smash
is
going to do it, and he is able to take out 1 on Luck.
That is very key. Good stuff for Autumn.
Whittle down shield pressure, so he is going to back up a little bit.
Yeah, that dare does so much shield damage, but it's better than actual
The fire jump punch coming through on a crew battle for the first round. And Autumn going out in style.
I'm here talking about shield damage. That did real damage.
That did physical, emotional damage.
Oh, man.
And yeah, even though Luck lost one himself, they have the slight advantage with it going 8-9 in favor of Team Pasta.
Oh man, yeah.
And up next will be
I believe this is I played him in bracket. I think it's Joshathan.
Joshathan, okay.
I want to say. He's a pretty solid Mario.
Mm.
So if he can get some Mario stuff going for him. Oh yeah, he's probably gonna have to put it in his tag.
That's true.
Yeah, so Luck's sitting pretty. It's a shame he had to lose that stock, but at least he didn't lose two.
yeah, that's true, yeah. But I mean, like, props to Autumn for actually being able to take out one as well.
Yeah, and now the goal for Luck is going to be to take at least one stock. Hopefully he can get that.
Yeah. Not last. Yes, he was not the last pick.
Wasn't Moosh last pick?
Yes, because people forgot about him. He was off to the other side.
No. It was funny because Biddy acknowledged him. He's just like, are we going to make Moosh last pick? And then
everyone said yes.
And then there were everybody else. And he was just like, all right, not Moosh. Get bodied. Sorry, Moosh.
Uh-huh. Vex is, yes, a team captain for Cruz.
Yeah, he's playing off stream.
Yeah.
His crew.
R2, yeah.
I don't know, dude. I mean, all I know is there's no freaking way. that your team's gonna win.
Okay.
I don't know, dude.
Upsets have happened before. And you'll be pretty upset once we take it.
How do I get it? I am not that linguistic. Oh, he's going cheek. I did not know that.
He has to take one stock off, and there will be a countdown that they'll shout out over there when they once they reset neutral. And 2-1, begin.
Go! Oh, boy.
Can he get the spike? Oh, he gets it! Oh!
He's still alive. Oh, gosh. Oh,
that was
gosh.
So close!
Sheik's recovery a little too good to let that
right.
happen.
Right.
But
oh
he
my
has
gosh.
To be shook. Now, I think there's an interesting thing about Sheik. If he isn't too familiar with Sheik's kill confirms, this may be a long-fought battle if he can't edgeguard Luck.
That is true. But in terms of the Sheik-Luigi battle, I really feel like if Sheik has to get in close, and as long as Luigi shields it and is able to capitalize off the either the end lag or just the player's inability to catch anything after that, that can lead to a grab into a throw combo.
Oh, boy, yeah.
Yeah, but as I was saying, that Luck leads with an up smash, and he's able to take a stock off another person while sitting pretty healthy himself right now.
Yeah, and it looks like Luck, steamrolling right now.
Luigi
combo. And he has
lapped him in percentage and is doing so much more.
Yeah, it looks like,
great shield there, though, from, what was his name?
Joshathan.
Joshathan, that's right. Tries to go pivot grab, but he dodges it.
Draft cruise with only two stocks. We got to get out of here, XX.
That's true, yeah. We have four teams with five people. That's 20 people all together, and this is only, like I said, basically...
Oh, no. But he's not going to get that big of a punish on
right.
it. He goes for a smash instead of trying to get positioning, and that's going to be two stocks.
Wow.
Luck does not lose a single one. Luck has taken four stocks, people.
Yes, that is 9-6 now.
I would say that's a pretty good
That is,
pick.
Yes, a huge divide, and Luck seems all but unstoppable right now. As Coach Pun steps up to the plate, tries to take this one stock that this team needs and to shut out Luck from taking any more and forcing another person to come up to the plate.
Oh, putting the timer on. Yeah. If some characters have stuff that needs time, like maybe Rob Laser or Wario.
Yes, Wario's Waff, things like that, yeah.
I don't think anybody I don't think anybody's using those characters, but just to be safe.
Yeah, that and the fact that they set it to 99, right?
Yeah, it was set to 91.
And they're keeping it so high just because, like, there is a rare chance that a timeout could happen, but they definitely want to rub that out as fast as they can.
Yeah. All right, so we'll see what the stage pick is here.
He banned Smash Bros, I believe. So, yeah, he was forced to pick Battlefield.
Battlefield, here we go.
And the character picks will be Ness and Luigi this time around.
All right. Let's see if Coach can make up some ground for his team here.
First stock has to be claimed because he lost one. And they will set back to neutral on the bottom, and one start.
Let's go. All right, immediately a fair train coming out. Just making it a little hard for Luck to get in, but
and
when he finally
that devastating
gets
grab combo again.
Yeah, he wanted to be safe about how he did it. He's okay with taking damage as long as he can take a stock before he takes too much.
Right. But I mean, so long as he keeps...
Oh, no!
And the early finish on this first stock! And again, Luck is only sitting with 17 damage this time! He is a beast!
You can't do this, Luck! Just let them do something! Oh my gosh! I mean, he's going for broke on those up B reads because how's he going to get punished for it? Like,
right.
If he gets a stock out of it, that's a really good trade.
Luigi is a rare beast in both stamina and now crew battles, I have learned.
Oh my goodness gracious. Oh boy, another one!
He's living through it this time, though. But that was definite. The percentage that should have definitely sent Ness out. So that was good DI from Coach.
I mean, Team James has really got to get some footing here.
Gets it back.
He's got an edge guard going.
Walls him out with the PK Thunder. Oh, but it forces him up with the bull pit.
Good air dodge there, but
He was waiting too long, and I think he's too low. Yeah.
Oh,
that is Luck out, thanks to Coach Pun coming through.
That was really clutch, but that's a lot of stocks for Luck.
Yes, that is.
He
claimed, what was it, five stocks in total.
Yeah.
And, yeah, that leaves Team James with 5 stocks to Team Pasta's now 6.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, James got a hard
No, it wasn't 6. It was 8. That's my fault. Yeah, because Locke was the first one to go.
Yeah.
It is 8-5. That's my fault.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so Locke definitely putting the team on his back there. Putting the team right in his fists, right. You know, those fiery, oh my gosh.
Right now I'm trying to check who's going on in the second match here, but it's blocked by another screen.
Yeah, either way, we've got Summer Haze coming up to go against Coach Pun. This is going to be interesting.
And yeah, since characters are locked, they know what they're going up against.
Yeah.
But at the same time, their characters are locked as well.
Yeah, so you think Summer Haze plays with Pasta a lot. So that's probably the logic behind that pick, right?
He has
a lot of Nessie.
Absolutely,
experience.
Yeah. I'd say that is that's the driving force behind that.
And especially, if Ness goes off stage, Villager presses neutral B and he's dead.
Yeah. Yeah. All he has to do is pocket PK Thunder.
Yep.
Doesn't he have to risk it with the drop air dodge, jump, and hit the PK Thunder to cancel it out?
He can just press B. It's done. Bye. So if he can get him off stage, that'll be huge. Limit reach, let's go. I didn't know this was Cloud.
Always to be... Oh, next one's Apostle. Okay, they're...
they're being nice.
Yeah.
Sarcasm. Nah, Apostle's sick.
Absolutely.
He's a freaking beast.
Alright, so let's see what Coach can do in terms of fighting that, trying to stay on stage, what you said was going to be one of the key factors here.
Yeah, I think... I don't know. I mean...
Can he do that many fair chases, I would say?
At 0, I'd think he'd do the normal 2. But,
right, but I mean, like, if he's going to go that far out, because you have to propel yourself forward while you're doing them.
That's true. He's definitely going to be cautious. I think Coach knows how he's going to probably approach this matchup.
Right, okay. So, yeah, it will be Ness and Villager coming up.
All right.
And stage pick will be pretty crucial, I'd say, here.
Yeah. This is going
to
be interesting.
Summer Haze wants to avoid both of the Animal Crossing stages.
Yeah, I'd say so because of the...
Yeah, he's going for... Oh, I thought he was going for Wide Blast Zones with Dreamland,
okay.
But okay.
Yep, Battlefield. Even though this was Coach's pick, I think Summer Haze is very comfortable in this stage as well. Because he can get sent out, and it doesn't matter because he's Villager.
Right, the way his Villager plays, he can do fair and bears so many times, and those platforms can offer a nice safe haven for him as well while he's doing that. One and begin.
All right. Summer Haze immediately the wall. That is not surprising in any way.
Void coming in.
Oh, yeah. Boy. Up air trying to link into something else, but not going to do it.
Stifles it out with neutral that time.
Yeah. Oh. Trying to get some kind of grab.
That grab's going to leave him pretty vulnerable. I mean, both these characters have a little iffy grabs. Villager more so than Ness. But
yeah.
The one thing that probably Summer Haze will be looking for is any opportunity he can get with PK Fire.
Oh, he redirected
it.
That was such a good bait.
Yes.
That was an amazing bait. He probably completely forgot about that. Oh, my gosh.
Plant but no water. And he's sent out to the side here. He does have amazing recovery. He does pocket PK Thunder wall out. Very nice.
Yeah, he might just want to throw that away. Like, I'm going to be real, because he doesn't want to hold on.
Oh,
to
but
that.
It does hit, and that'll be... Wow!
No!
And, yeah, the last part, like, just the leaves on the branches
were
able to hit him.
Look, Coach.
And that, yes, that was very low damage. I saw that.
Coach, I know you hate trees. I know you're trying to burn down that tree. But, like, what are you going to do if that tree falls on you?
Yeah.
Like, if you, it doesn't matter if the tree's on fire. You're going to die.
Poetic justice!
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
So Summer Haze taking that with a tree,
what
not losing anything.
Yes, he did not lose any of his stocks. And that'll be a very, very nice turnaround for what's happening here.
Yeah.
And now we have Nana, I believe, coming up.
Nana.
From Ghana. Yep.
Nana. He's going Diddy.
He's going Diddy, okay.
So that's going to be interesting because...
It's still going to be pretty hard, though, because... even though he has the added benefit of a little bit more speed, just the way that that Summer Haze plays Villager is just—it's so hard to approach the way he throws out those. I'm obviously speaking from first-hand experience.
Yeah,
I've been on the tail end of it, and I've been aggravated by it. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that's just only to show how good Summer Haze is with Villager.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. So the interesting thing here is Villager can pocket Banana.
Oh, yeah. That's true, too.
I know Blaziken has, our resident Diddy, has said a few things about the Villager-Diddy matchup and said he thought it was really, really bad until he realized that if you throw down Banana once when you get it...
It leaves it one more throw until it vanishes, right?
Yeah, so he can just throw it around, and he doesn't have to worry about Villager pocketing it up off the ground.
Right.
He can still pocket it from a throw, but chances are he's not going to react to that.
Right.
And then the Banana vanishes, and he still has Banana pressure. Not as much, but he still has it.
Yes, exactly.
So I don't know if Nana is going to do something like that, but this is it's tricky.
Mm. I'm wondering if he wants to take him to a tri-platform setup or something a little bit different. Because, just a little bit. A little bit differentiation because of Town and City cycling platforms.
All right, we're going to start right away, right?
Yep. Both have two stocks, so they're going to walk right into it, apparently.
A casual stroll into crew battles. Yeah, so Nana, oh my god.
Oh boy, the early taunts coming in from Ghana.
What's he doing, man?
He is trying to get Summer Haze tilted. Is what he's trying to do.
Oh, gets a banana. That's 4%. But, I mean, Nana's the last member other than James. James is gonna have to take as many stocks as Nana leaves. So
that is gonna be a huge hill to climb. And like I said, Village Summerace is just sitting comfortably by himself. Just
yeah, he doesn't
growing need- a little forest and doing his own. Trying to get his accuracy on point with that slingshot.
Yeah, like, he doesn't really need to approach or anything. Like, he's Villager. Mm. He has the lead. He can just do stuff, honestly.
But the lead almost shifted there.
Yeah. Just, actually up air too early.
Great pressure from Nana moving in on him, and because of that, it kept the percentages pretty even right now.
Oh.
Pockets the banana.
Yeah, that's the banana.
And I don't believe he down-throwed it, so he has two throws out of it, correct?
Well, yeah, but he can just refresh banana every 30 seconds, and I think Diddy will never be able to pull another banana.
Oh, wow. So, yeah, that's actually a really good tactic, keeping the banana away from Diddy.
Yeah.
Uses the Lloyd to actually get coverage so he can grow it.
They're refreshing the banana there.
Go down, let's see if he can edge guard up, force him up, and now it's Nana's turn. Good shield on Lloyd, but another back air from Summer Haze.
Yep.
And he'll grow the tree, or at least try to. Good option to recover high from Nana there.
Oof.
Long him out with these up airs, keeping him away from any sort of... getting ground on main stage here.
He's having a really tough time creating synthetic pressure without Banana. Like,
right.
Trying to get something started, but he
can't did pocket it. Peanut, though, as we saw there.
Yeah, so he didn't refresh Banana enough times. Now he can pull another Banana, but it looks like Nana isn't really aware. He's not
good
even...
Good thing he got hit with a Lloyd, because I thought he was going to go in, and that would have been a forward smash.
Oh, boy. Oh, are we going to get an edge guard here?
I don't think he's high enough. Oh, great stuff out from Summer Haze.
Yeah, that's pretty much free as Villager, as long as you don't kill yourself. Like,
right.
That's a gimp when Diddy's that low.
I mean, he's
looking
to get himself at 122, but we've seen crazier things happen just from luck taking down so many stocks on the other team here. So.
Oh, boy. Chucking him forward. See if he can get something started here.
Summer Haze is desperately trying to hold on, but just again, with the high percentage, he's being sent out on the side the entire time. He finally finds his way back to main stage and tries to apply a little more pressure so he can get the two-stock claim.
Oh, boy. Here we go. Trying to get a Villager train going. Nana's just having such a hard time sealing the stock.
He's playing so much of an aerial game that Nana's grounded game, for what I can see of Diddy Kong, is having a hard time getting those confirms and getting the damage he needs.
Yeah, and I don't think he's thrown out a single up smash or anything. Like, he hasn't thrown out a smash attack. He's trying to get the stock with up tilt.
He does have a peanut in hand, so he had to throw it away before using any other attack.
Yeah.
Great way, but he could have tried to go in after it, I think.
Yeah.
Banana is not in use.
I mean, Bowling Ball has actually very little end lag, so you gotta be careful about going in after that.
Oh, okay.
Oh, boy. Monkey flip kick going in, but Nana needs to take this stock.
Yeah.
That's just... That might do it. That's it.
Yes. All right. So he's able to take one for his team.
Oh, finally, Pine finally pulls another banana. I think he thought that Summer Haze had the banana the whole time, because he pulled it once Summer Haze died. So, that's interesting.
So, the tree is going to prevent him from using just about a third of the stage. Throws it up. Ooh. Oh, that was a triple, the triple turnip. That's the only one that spikes.
Trying to set up into that axe, but that's not working right now.
Can he get the damage needed? Diddy Kong can actually do it with his grab combos, but like we said before, Summer Haze has not given him a lot of opportunities to get those grabs that he needs.
Oh, boy. Trying to get something started. I think he was expecting a standard getup from Summer Haze, but Summer Haze mixing it up too much.
Oh, man. Alright, and on the other side of things, it seems that Esquire and Master Chef are headed at it now. I'm not sure on the stock count on that side, but that's Vex and Biddy's team going head-to-head. Our teams. Alright. I haven't been cycled out yet. I'm happy about that. Oh, he flipped through the break of the tree!
This man's got no fear!
Oh my gosh, that was incredibly ballsy.
Oh, it's Nana. I had to...
Yeah, Nana. Sorry about that. But, wow. I was just caught up in that. That was nuts.
Alright, Summer Haze. Only a little bit of percent to get. Back throw. That is the second strongest back throw, but it's not going to be enough to kill him just yet. Not enough rage. And also bad positioning on the stage, but whatever.
Right.
Dude, oh, really? What? Actually, he just walked into the straight Lloyd!
Cuts him off from watering the plant. Oh, ooh! He's going to hit by the Lloyd because he was charging that smash. Grows it. Chops on the wrong side. Okay, gets both.
Okay. The trap is set. He's got a peanut! He's got a peanut! He's not afraid to use it!
Everybody down!
Let's go! Back throw!
Back throw across stage.
Not going to be enough.
Back air will provide some sort of edge guard. He was looking to...
Nice.
Yeah.
Summer Haze with a brilliant stall!
Oh! I think he's done!
He is done!
He is shorted
Summer
out,
Haze
and Summer
will
Haze
take
is
Nana
able
out.
To triumph!
One stock on him. I'm gonna close the door!
And I mean, he was able to claim a stock on him, so definite props to him on that.
My bad, my boy.
Summer Haze coming through and keeping at least the player count in his team's favor. Right.
I feel good about Master Chef if he beats Esquire. All right. No, just because of matchup-wise. Unless I send out Vex prematurely. It's fine. Alright, so young Chilliger gonna be moving on. Taking out the monkey from out of town.
And it is Team James's last hope. DMG James himself.
I think he can do it.
I mean, yeah. He took stamina and singles today.
Yep, and he didn't even enter doubles. So he could have won that. Potential.
But I think
now, for those of you who don't know, characters are locked, and they were actually selected at the beginning before any matches were set.
Yep.
So he will be going Luigi for this. Now, Villager has a great job keeping Luigi out, so that is its own issue.
Uh-huh.
But he only has one stock to take, and this is DMG James we're talking about, the best Luigi in the tri-state area.
Yes, this is also true. So it could go either way. Will Summer Haze rise to the challenge and take out the king of Luigi's in the area?
How many stocks does Summer Haze's team have left?
Is it
just him?
He's losing one, so the count is off.
No, I mean, but like, is there anyone left on their team?
I know Luck was. I think there's one more.
Okay.
If anything, but I know James is.
So it's time for James's last stand. He's got that
nair
bust out.
They have seven, so they have four players still left, including Summer Haze.
Oh my God, getting some body bags.
But I mean,
right
percentages do reset to zero if you do claim. So
that's true.
That can definitely be a benefit to James.
Ooh, that was really good by Summer Haze actually. Just immediately pressuring him because he's shielded the lid.
Right. It's basically him trying to move up in winner's bracket and not losing once.
Fair.
And he did that. So, definitely.
Oh!
And he gets the flush, but Summer Haze
is
recovering.
Yeah, this is our Villager we're talking about. He's not going to just get gimped.
But I mean, even so, he tacked on damage with that with the two or three tornadoes.
This man has no chill!
Will he get back? Okay,
of course
he'll get back. Just making sure.
Oh,
and coming through, and he takes one stock off James. Here we go.
The bowling ball coming through. James getting a little reckless there.
And James only has one stock left to try and take out four players and seven stocks on the other side here.
I don't know. At the Rutgers tryouts, I took out six stocks on
that
my last one.
That will not do it just because of the wideness of Dreamland here. But he is sitting at 116.
Ooh,
he is poised to do it. Up
smash,
not going to do it. Yeah, it was only the starting hit of it.
Ooh. Yeah, James is
back.
He was trying
to
two-frame.
Oh, he went for a down throw. Okay.
Yeah, he was trying to two-frame there. The nair. Nair!
Nair
ladies
actually.
And gentlemen! The hard nair of Luigi. And that being said, it is Team James's last stock.
Yes, Team James and James himself is living on a prayer right now, living on this one stock. His entire team.
Living on a prayer!
Take James's hand and they'll make it maybe. Unbiased commentary.
Living on one stock. One stock. Three players. Can DMG James do it?
Oh, you're getting into it, huh?
Of course I am. I don't know. I like wiggling the headset. It's funny.
Oh my what? Gosh, yeah.
Why? Dude, our team got bodied a little bit. A little bit. Like, it's more like we got slowly bodied over a long period of time. It's weird.
Oh, I think it's good news for my team that I'm not out there yet. I think I'm
you're probably coming up next.
Last or second to last pick. Hmm. Or at least for the order of how this is going
assuming
down.
Assuming that they haven't
or
sent
maybe,
Vex out.
Or maybe Vex is saving himself for reserve.
I'm pretty sure Vex will save himself for last.
Okay. I don't even know what that means.
Nor do I. Oh, it's Deli.
Oh, is that what Little Dicky means?
Maybe.
All right. All
right, so here's the thing. I like this matchup. Korn absolutely outranges Luigi.
Uh-huh.
We'll see what he can do.
But I mean, like Master Chef said before he left, this is DMG James.
Exactly.
The best Luigi in Tri-State.
He is bullshit.
Come on.
I'm just joking. All right, but he has to take a stock.
Yeah, he Whee! Has one stock.
Let's do this.
3, 2, 1. Here we go.
Here we go. Deli has one stock to take. If he wants to, he can just not even focus. Oh, God.
Yes,
see, here's the thing. If I'm Deli, I'm not getting anywhere near this man. Like, I am spacing him out as best as I can when I saw that Nair land that close. I'm like,
yeah,
ooh.
Maybe because it is the last person on the team, he is playing aggressively, but you don't want to do that against Luigi.
Really, really, he should, he understands.
One practice much as James here.
Exactly. Because, like, when you do cruise, you have to understand this situation. I have one stock that I'm going to use to build up damage, and then I have another stock that I'm going to kill him with. But so far, he's taken 89%. 100%.
Compared to
only 20 on the other side.
A little scrape on the knee that Luigi has a bit right now.
Nice Dragon Lizard. I love the mix-up.
It's starting to bleed, but, you know, he can put up with it.
Ooh!
Counter coming through.
Counter.
On more
not
damage
even close to killing on the jab.
Back air going to force him out, and that'll be a stock take on Delibird as well. It is another 1-1 with a pretty healthy Luigi again.
Only 36%. Well, 46. 55.
Oh, we saw that on left side, I should say again. Yeah.
Yeah, again, that's a very unsafe. Because
down
like,
in the yeah,
Nair
neutral.
Is only safe if you space it perfectly.
Love that combo, the Nair and the Dare, off of a down air throw or down grab throw.
Yeah, Deli's got to be careful, because that's the other thing. Luigi has some of the easiest jab locks in the game because of his fireball. He's got to make sure he doesn't miss any ticks on the platforms.
Right, and that's going to keep pressuring him. Oh, wow, and pulling through is James, making it 4-1. Two people left, sending Delibird out. With nary a scratch on James's head. Yeah.
Did okay. He's not quite dead. He is, in fact, getting better. Two men to beat.
It is 4-1. If he can pull this off, I am...
I would assume
Moosh is coming up by the look of it.
I assume has... this is Pasta's team, right? So that means Pasta hasn't gone, I assume?
Yes. Pasta has not been up yet.
Okay.
It's just Moosh and Pasta left.
So, yeah. Can Moosh do it? I mean, I have faith in Pasta to take one stock off this man.
Now,
can Moosh do it early? Will Pasta have to show up?
Captain Falcon does give Luigi a little bit of a problem because of his speed. He can close that gap so fast, and just your reaction time has to be on point to be able to get anything off of Falcon while he's just creating so much pressure on you.
You betcha. Good thing you can't stale from the air. All right.
Gets a throw. Oh, he might be looking for an early finish on the first stock here, but Moosh opting to recover high.
Yeah. He's got to be careful because the flush is a huge threat.
And another down throw. Combo tax
Dare,
on Nair. Another
one.
30%.
59%.
I mean, just the combo did about 30.
That being said, Moosh, don't sleep on Moosh because this man is a master of two framing stomp. All right? He can kill this man dead if he doesn't recover correctly.
But he is having difficulty get the damage he needs right now.
Jab covers every option.
James just playing role games with him right now, keeping him on his toes.
But again, Moosh needs to focus not on killing. You just focus on percent.
Yes.
You have a stock.
But that's hard to do with Luigi's Nair breakup.
True. All right, know what he's trying to do.
I needed you.
No.
Say it. Oh, okay. I just moved it.
Okay.
Ooh. The back air, not going to do it.
He's taking 75%. The flush!
Stumps him
no!
out, but James is going down!
But he's got his double jump.
Wow! What an insane recovery from James!
He was
keeping
clean.
Keeping the hopes of his team alive!
This man was clean under Battlefield.
Like, even I thought he was gone. That just shows what an amazing job
Ooh,
that James
the tech
does.
On the stomp. But again, Moosh, the master of the two-frame stomp.
I thought it was all over there.
No, that James has to be really careful about air dodging here.
Oh, gets the tech.
Oh no!
The and Moose tried to go down and shut him out.
The buffer. That was a buffer. That was a
but
buffer error.
But it will be a 2-1 situation.
Blazing Pasta. Team Pasta's last hope. This just got really hyped for no reason.
Oh my, I am bewildered. I am speechless. Oh my gosh.
Oh. Here we go. It's a rematch of Grand Finals Stamina.
I will not be able to close my jaw for the rest of this match right now.
That was just a really unfortunate buffer by Moosh.
Oh my god.
Going for the gimps with the soft knee.
Yeah, he was just trying to stuff him out, but
it has next to no hit stun. So he was able to get back.
Yeah, the up B coming through and actually able to stifle it out a little bit for him to recover.
All right.
And one stock down.
That looks really funny.
This is it. Pasta has to take one, but James basically has to advance on in a regular bracket match here.
Mm-hmm. Question is, do we have faith in Also, James just, like, becomes...
I mean, with Pasta being high using
Pasta
the PR...
Pasta can't be reckless here. He will beat him up at low percent. He's already taken 53%.
That solid combo. He keeps doing that same combo, but it's paying off for him every time.
But no, Pasta, this man's number two in Philly for a reason.
Ooh. And actually, that's James giving Pasta the rush down in terms of the other, not the other way around. It's interesting. Mm-hmm. Oh, we got a little KK music here.
Mm-hmm. I like this song, actually. Yeah. Right. Landing without bear, because that's the safest option.
All right. Neutral, good
just, going for, just going for late nair.
Did you hear that sound effect?
That sounded like a bong. Like,
oh, yeah. That was KK. He can do that. Yeah.
Oh, okay. That was weird. I was like, I thought Luigi's butt made a weird sound at the third jab. All right.
Ooh, good nair out of shield. Yes. Oh, look for the
again,
back air.
Again, Pasta doesn't have to worry about killing right now. He just has to build up percent. Right. Ooh, going for pivot grabs. Ooh, that smash barely missing.
Does find purchase. Oh, try to jab lock or at least get
PK Fire doesn't jab lock.
Right, well, I mean, right before.
A tech chase.
Yeah, tech chase. Okay.
Ooh, okay. Gets a fair.
Comes in with fair.
Pasta doing a good job just not overextending. Just build the damage. Forward throw.
He was circumventing.
Is he going to go for the flush? No.
Nah, you don't challenge flush on a PK rocket.
Well, yeah, exactly. Exactly. He has to commit early to do that.
Gets the grab without using PK thumb.
And really, he has no reason to. It's too risky.
Good job baiting out that up smash so he can get safe recovery, but James forces him out yet again. Uh-huh. Oh, went for that time. Trying to go for the hip, and he gets one bounce off the stage spike.
The two frame on the forward air.
But he did do 87 damage.
Right.
He's very close to getting that 100%,
which
he needs for a back throw kill.
Ness is the scariest character in this game at high percents.
Yes.
So Pasta just needs a little bit more percent. Between up air as an aerial option and back throw, this man kills pretty much easier than anybody.
James
so he just needs a little bit.
He's going in safe with the jab so far. Really respecting Ness's command of just the movement right now, and he's just tacking on the damage needed, but he is so close to that 100%.
Ooh,
and there it is, the up air. He's not going to find another one.
Oh, man, he just barely missed the air dodge read.
Dash attack. Oh!
Okay.
Let him recover safe.
Yeah. He's waiting on the edge. He's just standing there.
Oh, my gosh.
Menacingly.
Looking for this grab, but James gets one. Pasta breaks
out.
Oh, he almost had a grab!
He could have had the pivot grab there.
But he entered into the slide animation! And
just
James is out! And Pasta claims it for his team!
Pasta clutches it out, just surviving long enough to let the Star KO finish it off.
It came down to, what was it?
The last
8-5, and then a reversal from James coming through.
James.
So many things happened.
James
led to a 1v6.
James was utterly amazing in his loss.
He claimed 5 stocks before someone could shut him down, and it was down to the last situation.
The last stock of Pasta.
Both of them were going down, and it was just...
And that's why these guys are top players. They get the high percentage situations
and
don't choke it up.
Shout
out to me.
This warrants a curse. I'm going to say a curse. Let's fucking go.
Oh, shit, man. Is this like a double elimination cruise?